Hvordan de stoler der. And Carl, I will introduce in Danish, okay?
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, okay. Carl Martin er pastor i Central Kirke i Edinburgh. Han er gift, og han har 4 piger. Carl, han længes efter at se kirken vågne op og blive det Guds folk, som den er kaldet til, siger han. Og så kommer det vigtigste. Carl, han elsker sport. Han elsker vin. Så hvis du har vin i forteltet, så er han den helt rigtige mand at invitere. Og så er det noget med Arsenal support.
Come on.
Ja, så, tolken skal ikke snydes. Det er Sune Andersen, og Sune, du bor sammen med Carrie og jeres to drenge. Ja, i Aarhus. Og Sune er leder af Kirkeplanternet Danmark, og derudover så er I en del af Aarhus Valgmenighed. Og vigtigst af alt for jer måske, bor I Gellerup Parken i Aarhus, og er en del af en klynge, der hedder Ghetto Fever, hvor I ønsker at nå Gellerup med Guds kærlighed. Ja.
Ja, vi vil bede for, jeg beder for Carl, og ja, giv dem endelig en hånd.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Men det er han. Okay.
Well.
Do you need to stay here? Just in front of that line.
Perfect.
Okay. Yeah. I pray for you. Vi beder for Carl og for Sune. Kære herre, vi beder om, du vil være med Carl nu, han skal tale til os. Beder dig om at give ham inspiration og glæde. Og ja, netop ordet fra dig, herre. Amen.
Thank you. Perfect. Well, thank you very much for your welcome.
Tusind tak for jeres velkomst.
I've just been texting my wife and my girls and telling them how cool you are.
Jeg har lige SMS'et min kone og min døtre for at fortælle hvor cool I ser ud.
I said there were more kind of hipster Christians in Denmark than I've ever seen anywhere else.
Der er flere hipster-kristne i Danmark, end jeg har set nogen andre steder.
Even the old people are cool.
Selv de gamle er cool.
The boss man wears Vans.
The boss man, the leader, Carsten, wears Vans. Woo!
It's cool.
I don't know what that is.
No, I have no idea either.
Vi ved ikke, hvad det er.
It's brilliant to be here. I would love just to pray for us again.
Det er fantastisk at være her. Jeg beder lige for os.
And invite the Holy Spirit to come.
Og inviter Helligånden til at komme.
So maybe you'll hold out your hands.
Hold jeres hænder ud.
Father, we love you.
Fader, vi elsker dig.
Jesus, we honor you and worship you.
Jesus, vi ærer dig og tilbeder dig.
And the Holy Spirit, we welcome you.
Helligånd, vi byder dig velkommen.
Would you speak to us in the way that you do?
Vil du tale til os på den måde du gør?
Would you encourage us, challenge us, and stir us?
Vil du opmuntre os, udfordre og berøre os?
That we would leave this place different.
At vi vil forlade dette sted for andre.
We ask this in Jesus' name.
Vi beder dette i Jesu navn.
Amen.
Amen.
So I was at a conference maybe about 10 years ago, and there was a Chinese pastor speaking.
Jeg var på en konference cirka 10 år siden, og der var en kinesisk præst, der talte.
And his name was Brother Yun.
Og hans navn var Broder Yun.
And he wrote a book called The Heavenly Man.
Og han forfattede en bog, der hed den hellige mand.
And I was sitting right at the back of this meeting.
Og jeg sad helt bagerst i et møde som det her.
And about 300 people from my church were there.
Og omkring 300 mennesker fra min kirke var der.
And Brother Yun has a fascinating style of preaching.
Og Brother Yun har en fascinerende måde at prædike på.
He doesn't speak much English.
Han taler ikke særlig meget engelsk.
He speaks Cantonese.
Han taler kantonesisk.
And he has an interpreter.
Og han har en oversætter.
And he said what seemed to me to sound like this.
Og Broder Yun sagde, hvad der lød til mig som.
And his interpreter,
og hans oversætter,
she said,
hun sagde, Anyone who needs to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ, come to the front now.
Er der nogen her, der har brug for at kende frelseren Jesus Kristus, så kom foran nu.
And he'd been speaking for 2 minutes.
Og han havde talt i 2 minutter.
He hadn't explained the cross, he hadn't explained the resurrection, nothing.
Han havde ikke forklaret korset eller genopstandelsen.
I hated him at that moment.
Jeg hadede ham det øjeblik.
It takes me 45 minutes.
Det tager mig 45 minutter.
And I don't get the same response.
Og jeg får slet ikke den samme respons.
10 minutes later, he says, ha, ha, ha.
10 minutter senere siger han,
ha, ha. And the lady says, all of you who are church leaders, come to the front now.
Og oversætterdamen siger, alle dem, der leder i kirken, kom foran nu.
And I just sit there.
Og jeg sad der bare.
All the other godly church leaders start coming to the front.
Alle de andre fromlige kirkeledere kom frem.
And I just sit there.
Og jeg sidder der bare.
And my wife looks at me.
Og min kone kigger på mig.
And I just sit there.
Og jeg sidder der bare.
And then she elbows me.
And there, og så giver hun mig en albue lige i ribbenet.
And I stand.
Og så står jeg op.
As I stand, Brother Yun says, ha, ha.
Lige da jeg rejser mig op, så siger Brother Yun, hulie.
And the lady says, everyone here who has a problem with pornography, come to the front now.
Og damen siger, hvis der er nogen, der har et problem med pornografi, skal I komme op frem nu.
And I'm standing.
Og jeg står der.
And then I have a choice.
Så har jeg et valg.
Do I do the walk of shame?
Går jeg skammens gang?
Or do I sit down very quickly?
Eller skynder jeg mig at sætte mig ned?
I walk.
Jeg går.
And I can see members of my congregation going, uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Og jeg kan se medlemmerne fra min kirke kigge over og gå, ja, ja.
Now, I don't actually have a problem with pornography. I've got a whole bunch of other problems.
Jeg har faktisk ikke et problem med pornografi. Jeg har mange andre problemer.
But what I found is that when I made myself vulnerable, God showed up.
Men da jeg gjorde mig selv svag, så kom Gud til stede.
And when God shows up and does something in my life,
og når Gud kommer til stede og gør noget i mit liv,
I just lose it. I weep, snot comes out of my nose, I'm just a wreck.
Så mister jeg bare alt, og snot kommer ud af næsen, og jeg græder, og jeg er bare et vrag.
And funny as the story it is, that moment was a turning point for me and my ministry.
Og selvom det er en sjov historie, så var det et omdrejningspunkt, en ændring, en forandring i min ledelse og i min ministry.
Sometimes God just sets you up.
Nogle gange så lokker Gud dig.
I have discovered that God often roadblocks my way, arrests my heart, changes my direction.
Jeg oplever, at Gud sætter vejspærringer op, at han kommer i mit hjerte og sætter en ny retning.
I think the Lord has given me a word for you this evening.
Jeg tror, Gud har givet mig et ord til jer i aften.
And I think the word is this. God is setting you up.
Og jeg tror, at Gud, at ordet er, Gud lokker dig. Han sætter en konstruktion op for dig til at gå ind i.
Your nation, like my nation, like most nations in the world, are in a crisis.
Din nation, Danmark, ligesom min nation, er i en krise.
A crisis of family, a crisis of nation, a crisis of leadership, a crisis in the church.
En krise for familie, en krise i lederskab.
A crisis of finance.
En finansiel krise.
And the thing is, it's different crisis because no one's pretending it's not a crisis anymore.
Og det er en anderledes krise, fordi nu kan vi ikke lade som om der ikke er en krise mere.
No one's pretending it's an easy fix. We can solve it. We can sort it out. One day it'll be better.
Der findes ikke en hurtig løsning, hvor en dag så vil det bare være bedre.
But God is setting you up.
Men Gud sætter dig op. Han lokker dig.
God is setting you up and raising up a people to change a nation.
Gud lokker dig og et folk til at ændre en nation.
God is wanting to free you so that a nation might be free.
Han vil sætte dig fri, så hele nationen kan blive fri.
The transformation God wants to do through you, he first has to do in you.
Den forvandling, som Gud vil gøre igennem dig, skal han først gøre i dig.
And I want to read to you a story in the scriptures where God set his people up.
Og jeg vil læse en historie fra bogen, hvor Gud han lokker sit folk.
And you'll find it in the book of Judges.
Det er i Dommerbogen.
And chapter 6.
Kapitel 6.
We're going to read.
You start and then we'll see what happens.
Yeah. So let's read together. If you've got your Bibles, let's open them. Let's check out whether the preacher's telling the truth.
Og lad os læse det her sammen. Så hvis du har en bibel, så åbne den op og find ud af, om ham, der giver talen, han taler sandhed.
So we read this. Thank you. Again, the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord, and for 7 years he gave them into the hands of the Midianites. Because the power of Midian was so oppressive, the Israelites prepared shelters for themselves in mountain clefts, caves, and strongholds. Whenever the Israelites planted their crops, the Midianites, Amalekites, and other eastern peoples invaded the country. They camped on the land and ruined the crops all the way to Gaza and didn't spare a living thing for Israel, neither sheep nor cattle nor donkeys. They came up with their livestock and their tents like swarms of locusts. It was impossible to count the men and their camels. They invaded the land to ravage it. Midian so impoverished the Israelites that they cried out to the Lord for help.
Ja. Israelitterne gjorde, det er Dommerbogen kapitel 6, vers 1. Israelitterne gjorde, hvad der var ondt i Herrens øjne. Herren gav dem i midjanitternes hånd, og i 7 år havde midjanitterne magten over Israel. Af frygt for dem indrettede israelitterne tilflugtssteder i bjergene, huler og klippeborge. Hver gang israelitterne havde sået, kom midjanitterne og amalekitterne og østens folk og gik til angreb på dem. De slog lejr på deres jord og ødelagde landets afgrøde helt til Gaza. De lod intet være tilbage at leve i Israel, heller ikke får, okser eller æsler. For de kom med deres hjorte og deres telte, så talrige som græshopper. Hverken de eller deres kameler kunne tælles. De trak ind i landet og hærgede det. Israel blev helt forarmet på grund af midjanitterne, og så råbte de til Herren.
Ja. Just read on, verse 11.
Så læser vi fra vers 11. Herrens engel kom og satte sig under en i Ofra, som tilhørte Abesritten Joas. Hans søn Gideon var ved at tærske hvede i vindperseren, for at have den i sikkerhed for midjanitterne. Herrens engel viste sig for ham og sagde til ham, Herren er med dig, tapre kriger. Gideon sagde til ham, Hør mig, herre, hvis Herren er med os, hvorfor har alt dette så ramt os? Hvor er alle de under, som vores fædre fortalte os om, når de sagde, Herren førte os op fra Egypten. Nu har Herren forkastet os og givet os i midjanitternes magt. Så vendte Herren sig til Gideon og sagde, Drag afsted i al din styrke, så skal du frelse Israel fra midjanitterne. Det er mig, der sender dig. Gideon sagde til ham, Hør mig, herre, hvordan skulle jeg kunne frelse Israel? Min slægt er den mest ubetydelige i Manasse, og jeg er den yngste i min fars hus.
And verse 25.
Og så læser vi vers 25. Samme nat sagde Herren til ham, Tag en af din fars tyre, en fuldvoksen 7-årig tyr. Riv så din fars Baals alter ned, og hug Asherah-pælen om, som står ved siden af. På toppen af denne fæstningsklippe skal du bygge et alter for Herren, din Gud, på den foreskrevne måde. Så skal du tage den fuldvoksne tyr og bringe den som brændeoffer. Asherah-pælen, som du har hugget om, skal du bruge som brænde.
Så. God is in the business of calling a people to change a nation. The nation is in bondage.
Gud handler om at ændre en nation. Nationen er i slaveri.
The eastern tribes had come, taken the crops and the donkeys randomly.
Stammerne fra østen, de havde simpelthen kommet, og de havde taget æslerne sådan helt haphazardly.
The people of God are hiding in caves.
Guds folk gemmer sig i huler.
Today we call them churches.
I dag kalder vi dem kirker.
And the potential leaders are about domestic duties.
Og de potentielle ledere har daglige gerninger.
Gideon is in a wine press threshing wheat.
Gideon er i vindperseren, hvor han forbereder hveden.
If you're a leader here today, have you ever felt like it's just about doing domestic duties?
Hvis du er en leder her i dag, oplever du så nogle gange, at det bare er dagligdagen?
I mean, you've got to provide another inspirational talk to the same old people on Sunday.
du skal lave en inspirationel tale for de samme gamle mennesker på søndag.
You got to visit all those difficult people who are making your life hard.
Du skal besøge alle de her vanskelige mennesker, som bare gør dit liv svært.
Who might be sitting right next to you right now.
Som måske sidder lige ved siden af dig lige nu.
God is setting you up to free a nation.
Gud gør dig klar, han sætter dig op til at befri en nation.
But before we see freedom in the nation, we have to see freedom in our lives.
Men før vi ser frihed for nationen, så skal vi se frihed i vores liv.
See, God is in the business of taking you and positioning you in the center of his repair job for Denmark.
Fordi Gud, han vil tage dig og sætte dig i centret af hans job til at reparere, genoprejse Danmark.
And the great thing is that God uses and chooses unlikely people.
Og den fantastiske ting er, at Gud, han vælger usandsynlige mennesker.
Like you.
Ligesom dig.
I mean, turn and look at the person sitting next to you.
Prøv lige at vende dig om og kigge på den, der sidder ved siden af dig.
And tell them that they are an unlikely person.
Du er et usandsynligt valg.
You wouldn't want them in your army.
Du skulle helst ikke være i min her.
But God's choosing you anyway.
Men Gud, han vælger dig alligevel.
You see, Gideon is a wimp.
Gideon, han er en svækling.
He's a coward.
Han er en kujon.
He's in a wine press doing something he shouldn't be doing in a wine press because he's scared.
Han er en vinpres og gør der som han egentlig ikke skulle gøre bare fordi han er bange.
Threshing wheat would happen in the open air in this kind of wind.
Han tærsker korn, det vil han gøre i den åbne vind.
Not under the ground.
Ikke under jorden.
And an angel appears to him.
Og en engel kommer foran ham.
And says, "Mighty warrior."
Og han siger, mægtige kriger.
God is in the business of choosing unlikely people.
Gud, han vælger usandsynlige mennesker.
It's the way he rolls.
Det er den måde han ruller på.
Throughout the scriptures.
Igennem hele Bibelen.
He chooses Noah to be involved in one of the most cataclysmic moments in Old Testament history.
Han vælger Noah til at være i en af de mest kataklystiske begivenheder i det gamle testamente.
It's going great. It's going great. Yeah. Is he just saying whatever he wants to say? Perfect. You sit down. I'll do this. So Noah gets out of the ark. God has saved him, and he gets drunk. The first thing he does.
Noah, han kommer ud af arket, og det første han gør, da han kommer ud, det er at blive fuld.
Abraham is the great man of faith throughout the New Testament, again and again and again. Abraham is the model and the example of faith.
Igennem hele det gamle testamente er Abraham bare modellen for trofasthed og for tro.
Abraham pimps his wife, sleeps with a maid, and laughs in the face of God.
Han prostituerer sin kone. Han griner i ansigtet af
laughs in the face of God.
Han griner af Gud.
Uh-huh. These are unlikely people.
Det er usandsynlige mennesker.
James and John, favorites of Jesus, called sons of thunder, not because they were good at weather forecasting, but because they had anger issues.
Jakob og John blev kaldt tordens lynild. Ikke fordi at de var meteorologer, men fordi at de var havde et vredesudbrud.
The apostle Peter, frequently wrong but never in doubt.
Apostlen Peter tager ofte fejl, men er aldrig i tvivl.
And you, with all your insecurities, all your hang-ups, all your problems, all your past, all the how can it be me, I'm the weakest and the lowest and the most useless.
Og dig med alle dine usikkerheder, du som er den mindste, den mest uværdige, den mest usandsynlige. Hvad med dig?
The Lord says, you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Du er frygtløs og lavet som et mesterværk.
You're a child of the living God.
Du er et barn af den levende Gud.
You're a friend of Jesus. You're the workmanship of the divine.
Du er en ven af Jesus. Du er et kraftværk af det guddommelige.
You are blood-bought, spirit-filled, mighty warriors.
Let's take it.
Du are blood-bought,
spirit-filled. Fyldt af min ånd.
Mighty warriors.
Mægtige krigere.
You're playing small doesn't do the kingdom of God any good.
Når du spiller og leger lille, så gør det ikke Guds rige noget godt.
Would you stop hiding in wine presses?
Stop med at gemme dig i vinpærseren.
And would you stand and would you speak and would you speculate?
Stå og tal og spekulere.
Because God is setting you up.
Fordi Gud han kalder dig.
For the transformation of this nation.
For at forvandle denne nation.
I need you to recognize that God is wonderfully patient with your faith journey.
Du skal genkende, at Gud er fantastisk.
Faith journey?
Nej.
No. He's just wonderfully patient with you. God is wonderfully patient with you.
Han er fantastisk tålmodig med dig og din trosrejse. We get that.
Gideon meets this warrior angel. I mean, let's get over the idea that angels are little chubby things with bows and arrows.
Gideon, han møder den her krigerengel, og lad os lige komme over det der med engle, de små for tykke drenge med lille bue.
And the angel says, mighty warrior.
Og englen siger, mighty warrior.
I choose to believe that God doesn't do sarcasm.
Hvorfor vælger du, at Gud, ja, og jeg vælger, at Gud ikke er sarkastisk.
He's speaking prophetically. This is
Han taler profetisk
this is
til dig.
You will be. And the first
det er
den,
du er.
The first thing that Gideon says,
den første ting, Gideon siger,
I want a sign.
Jeg vil have et tegn.
I mean, what other sign do you need?
Hvad for andet tegn har du brug for?
A warrior angel has just met you in a wine press.
En krigerengel har lige mødt dig i vinpærseren.
I mean, get over yourself.
Kom nu lidt.
I mean, I would have chosen someone else.
Jeg ville have valgt en anden.
I'd have said, God, I'm not using him. We'll go somewhere else.
Hvis jeg var Gud, så ville jeg sige, ham der, ham bruger vi ikke. Lad os finde
But God is wonderfully patient with your journey.
Men Gud er fantastisk tålmodig med
every,
din rejse.
Every year you come to Oasis.
Hvert år så kommer du her til Oasis.
And every year you're sniveling down at the front.
Og hver år så ligger du et tuder her nede foran.
Because the Lord has met you.
Fordi Gud han har mødt dig.
And all on the altar I lay.
Og lige på alteret lå jeg.
And I will serve you, and I will transform everything around me, and I will go for you 100%.
Og jeg ligger der, og jeg siger, jeg vil tjene dig, og jeg vil gå for dig 100%. Jeg alt er inde i det her.
And 2 weeks later, you've broken every vow.
Og 2 uger senere, så har du brugt alle dine løfter.
And you've taken yourself back off the altar.
Og du har taget dig selv af alteret igen.
And God is wonderfully patient with your faith.
Og Gud er fantastisk tålmodig med din trosrejse.
His grace is enormous for you.
Hans nåde er uendelig til dig.
And he's setting you up.
Og han lokker dig, han
kalder dig. He's setting you up. The Lord is powerfully present in his call.
Herren er kraftfuld til stede i sit kald.
If you have your Bibles, just take a look with me at verse 34.
Prøv lige at tage Bibel og kigge på vers 34.
It says in your version, the Spirit of the Lord came upon Gideon.
Det står her i Bibelen, da iklædte Herrens ånd sig Gideon.
Its better translation is this, the Lord put Gideon on.
En bedre oversættelse af den er, at Herren tog Gideon og tog ham på.
Like a glove or like a suit
ligesom
of armor.
Ligesom en handske eller en rustning.
The Lord filled Gideon so completely that there was nothing really left of Gideon. It was just the Lord in Gideon.
Gud han fyldte Gideon så meget, at der slet ikke var noget af Gideon tilbage. Det var bare Guds ånd i Gideon.
I need to tell you this.
Jeg er nødt til at fortælle jer det her.
That if the Lord calls you to something and you lay it on the altar and you say, wherever you send, I will go. Whatever you say, I will do. He always... You'll do that.
Ja. Så hvis du lægger dig på alderet, og du siger til Gud, jeg vil gå derhen, hvor du sender mig. Jeg er 100% trofast mod dig.
He always aligns it with the ability, the supernatural ability to do exactly what he's asked you to do.
Så giver han dig alt det supernaturlige, overnaturlige, du har brug for
at
lykkes.
Every part of his power, every part of his authority,
kraft,
every part
hele
of his
autoritet, alt hans nåde.
When Jesus says, "Go into all the world, preach, teach, and make disciples," he sends the Holy Spirit.
Når Jesus siger, "Gå ind i verden og lav disciple,"
he says, "If you forgive,"
han sin ånd.
He says, "If you forgive people their sins, they're forgiven. If you don't forgive people, they're not forgiven. What more power do you need or want?"
Hvis du tilgiver folk deres synd, så er den tilgivet. Hvilken anden kraft ønsker du end den?
The Lord is setting you up.
Gud han kalder, han lokker.
The Lord is setting you up.
Gud han lokker dig nu.
But you need to know this.
Men du har brug for at vide det her.
Before you see victory in this nation.
Før du ser sejren i den her nation.
You will have to dismantle the altars and idols in your back garden.
Så er du nødt til at destruere de alter og idoler du har i baghaven.
Gideon was told, "Look, if you're going to build an altar to me," the Lord says.
Gideon han blev fortalt af Gud, at hvis du skal bygge et alter til mig,
you better get in your back garden and dismantle the altar and the idol that have been erected by your father.
Så skal du ind i baghaven, og skal du fjerne de alter og de idoler, som dine fædre har stillet op der.
And if you're going to see victory in this nation, if you're going to see breakthrough, If we're going to see hundreds and thousands of people come to know the Lord and lives transformed and a nation changed.
Hvis du skal se gennembrud og sejre og omvendelse i den her nation, så se 100.000 vis af mennesker komme til tro, så skal du ind i haven.
Then you better do some business with the altars and the idols and the strongholds that are in your back garden.
Så skal du ind og så skal du destruere de alter og idoler der er i din baghave.
You didn't put them there.
Du satte dem ikke op der.
Your forefathers put them there.
Din forfædre satte dem der.
But you have to dismantle them.
Men det er dig der skal destruere dem.
Because if you don't dismantle them,
fordi hvis du ikke destruerer dem,
you will live in defeat.
Så lever du i nederlag.
And your kids will have to dismantle them for you.
Og så skal dine børn til at nedbryde dem for dig.
And you say, Carl, but they are Baal and Asherah, idols and poles. I mean, this is today. This is not 2,000 years ago, 3,000 years ago, 4,000 years ago.
Men du siger, Carl, tag dig lige sammen. Det er Baal og Asherah. Ja, det er jo tusindvis af år siden. Tag dig lige sammen.
And I say, yeah, but
Baal. Og jeg siger, ja.
But Baal is the god of money and success.
Men Baal er idol for succes om penge.
And Asherah is the goddess of sex, fertility, and fun.
Og Gud er Asherah er gudinde for sex og underholdning.
And they're our fathers' gods.
Og de er vores forfædres gud.
What stops you cutting them down?
Hvad er det der forhindrer dig, stopper dig i at nedbryde dem?
What stops me cutting them down?
Det der stopper mig for at nedbryde dem.
My addiction to approval stops me cutting them down.
Det er min synd i at vil have anerkendelse.
I still live with the words in my ears. You need to be respectable.
Jeg lever stadig med de her ord i mine ører. Du skal være respektabel.
What will they think of you?
Hvad vil de tænke om dig?
Don't get above your station.
Du skal ikke hæve dig over din plads.
It must look right.
Det skal se rigtigt ud.
It must be acceptable to everyone.
Det skal være acceptabelt for alle.
It's religion.
Det er religion.
And it's a very respectable thing.
Og det er en meget respektabel ting.
But it is a very empty thing.
Men det er en meget tom ting.
And unless we break these idols, unless we deal with these strongholds.
Og medmindre vi nedbryder de her idoler og fæstninger.
It will keep us from living counterintuitively and counterculturally.
Så vil det stop os fra at leve i modkultur.
It'll stop us as Jesus asks us to seek in seeking first the kingship of Jesus and his restorative justice.
Det vil stoppe os fra først at søge Gud eller for Jesus og søge af kongerigets restauration.
It'll mean that we're always just condemning culture and consuming culture and critiquing culture and copying culture and never creating it.
Vi vil fordømme og forbruge kultur, men vi vil aldrig komme til at skabe det.
Because we're frightened to put our head above the parapet and say this is the way, let's walk in it.
Fordi vi er bange for at putte hovedet op over vandet og sige det her, det vil vi ikke gå med.
Unless we cut down these altars and these idols, we'll never have freedom to be abandoned in worship as we really want to be.
Og medmindre vi nedlægger de her idoler, så vil vi aldrig have frihed i at tilbede sådan som vi ønsker.
We will always be more concerned about everyone else than we are about him.
Vi vil altid være mere optaget af hvad andre tænker end hvad han tænker.
And we'll be looking around saying, what do they think about us?
Og vi kigger rundt og tænker, hvad er det de, hvad tænker de om os?
Unless we cut these idols down and get rid of them.
Medmindre vi får de her idoler fjernet.
We will never be radically free to look for people of peace and share our faith unashamedly with them.
Så vil vi aldrig finde fredens personer og dele evangeliet uden skam med dem.
Because we'll still be obsessed with being respectable. What will they think of us?
Fordi vi vil være så optaget af at tænke og være respektabel og tænke, hvad tænker de om os?
Unless we get rid of these idols, my friends.
Medmindre vi kommer af med de her idoler.
We will never ever walk into the big dreams that God has for our lives.
Så vil vi aldrig nogensinde komme til at gå ind i de store drømme Gud har for os.
I had a vision meal last year with the church that I pastor.
Jeg havde en visionsmåltid med den kirke, som jeg leder.
We sat about 450 people down for dinner.
Vi sidder cirka 450 mennesker ned og spiser.
And I shared the vision with the core group.
Og jeg deler visionen med kernen.
For a movement of churches that were planted all over the nation, centers of mission that transformed Scotland and Ireland.
For en bevægelse over nationen, center for mission, som forvandler Skotland og Irland.
And the majority of people were very excited about that vision.
Og størstedelen af folk, de var meget glade for den og meget excited.
But I had a number of people saying to me, Carl, that's arrogant.
Men der var et par stykker, som kom op og sagde, det der, det er arrogant, Carl.
Don't get ahead of yourself.
Du skal ikke komme over dig til dig.
What will they think of us?
Hvad vil de ikke tænke om os?
Why would we think that we could do this?
Hvorfor skulle vi tro, at vi kunne gøre det?
My friends,
mine venner,
unless your vision is not intimidating to you,
med mindre at din vision ikke gør dig selv bange,
it may well be insulting to God.
Så vil det måske være fornærmende for Gud.
He wants to do immeasurably more than we ask or imagine.
Han vil gøre så meget mere end det vi kan spørge om eller fantasere os til.
He's not just interested in the reformation of the church.
Han vil ikke bare se reformationen af kirken.
He is passionately interested in the transformation of the world.
Han vil passioneret se verden blive forvandlet.
Are we going to change the way we think?
Vi er nødt til at ændre den måde vi tænker på.
For an obsession with the 3% of people who are already interested in what we're doing.
I stedet for at bare være der for de 3%, som allerede er interesseret i det vi gør.
To begin to worry and be transformed by the 97% who don't know Jesus and aren't interested.
Så lad os bekymre om de der 97%, som ikke er interesseret, ikke kender Jesus.
Because Jesus came saying the kingdom is at hand.
Fordi Jesus han kom og sagde at Guds rige er hånden.
You can reach out and touch it.
Nå, det er Guds rige er nær. Du kan række ud og røre ved den.
And tonight I think.
Og i aften så tænker jeg.
That God may well whisper to you and remind you of the dream that he's placed in your heart.
Så vil Gud hviske til dig om den drøm som han har givet dig og placeret i dit hjerte.
I want you to cut down the altars.
Jeg vil have at du skærer de her altre ned i din baghave.
Of your fathers.
Din forfædres idoler.
It'll get you into trouble.
Det vil kun skabe vanskeligheder.
But it'll free you up to live.
Men det vil sætte dig fri til at leve.
Mighty warriors.
Mægtige krigere.
See, Gideon didn't ask permission, he just banked on getting forgiveness.
Så Gideon han spurgte ikke om tilladelse. Han vil bare have tilgivelse.
So some of you need to get rid of your Baal altars.
Så nogle af jer er nødt til at få fjernet de her Baal altre.
Your obsession with success and achievement and stuff, and you never meant it to be that way, but that's what's been sown into your life.
Din optagethed du har med penge og succes, du vil ikke have det på den måde, men det er bare kommet ind i dit liv og det styrer det.
You know that the equation of this world is that your skills plus your effort equal your success.
Men formlen i den her verden er at dine færdigheder plus skills plus
your effort
på din effekt
equals your success.
Det bliver lige med din succes.
And I don't know if this is true for you, so humor me for a moment.
Jeg ved ikke om det her det er rigtigt for dig.
There's some crazy stuff going on in Scotland.
Men der er noget vildt der sker i Skotland.
So in Scotland, here's the deal.
I Skotland der er det sådan her.
You know, we work really hard to live in the right houses in the right neighborhoods so we can get our kids into the right schools.
Vi arbejder rigtig hårdt for at bo i de rigtige naboskaber for at få børnene i de rigtige skoler.
We force our kids to work hard so they get the right results in their grades so they can get to the right universities.
Og vi tvinger vores børn så de kan komme i de rigtige skoler, arbejde hårdt og få de rigtige
We tell them to work really hard at university. Don't
skal arbejde rigtig hårdt på universitetet.
Don't party too much because then
feste for meget.
Because then you can get a really good job.
Fordi så kan du få et rigtig godt job.
So you can earn enough money to move into the right neighborhoods.
Så du kan tjene nok penge til at flytte ind i de rigtige naboskaber.
Right,
så du kan sende dine børn til de rigtige skoler.
So they can work really hard.
Så de kan arbejde rigtig hårdt.
And they can get the right results.
Og de kan få de rigtige resultater.
So they can go to really good universities.
Så de kan gå til rigtig gode universiteter.
So they can get great jobs.
Så de kan få rigtig gode jobs.
So they can buy nice houses in the right areas.
Så de kan købe nogle rigtig fine huse i nogle rigtig gode omgivelser.
And someone needs to say stop.
Er nødt til at sige stop.
The world's gone crazy.
Verden er gået fra forstanden.
And you have no time.
Og du har ikke tid.
To run with the adventure that God has given you.
Du har ikke tid til at løbe med det eventyr som Gud har givet dig.
Because you're not just earning the stuff, you're sustaining the stuff.
Fordi du tjener ikke bare stoffet. Du får det til at blive bæredygtigt.
And you begin.
Og du begynder
to think that that's the way God rolls as well.
Og du tror at det er den måde Gud han ruller på.
That if you work really hard for him.
At hvis du arbejder rigtig hårdt for ham.
That if you use your skills for him.
Hvis du bruger alle dine færdigheder for ham.
Then in heaven somewhere he's going.
Så vil han op i himlen klappe af dig.
The fact is this.
Men fakta er det her.
His grace means that all the time in heaven he's going.
Men det der betyder det er hans nåde i himlen er han klapper hele tiden af dig. Det er det Guds nåde betyder.
His grace means he loves you because he loves you because he loves you because he loves you.
Hans nåde betyder at han elsker dig fordi han elsker dig fordi han elsker dig fordi han elsker dig.
You've got to get rid of the altar.
Vi er nødt til at få fjernet de her altre.
And some of us have to cut down the Asherah pole.
Og nogle af os vi skal få den der pole, Asherah pole til at falde. Stang.
The enemy attacks us with addictions to food and sex and Facebook and internet and all these other things that they're not bad or they're wrong, but they just suffocate the God life in us.
Og fjenden, han angriber os med alle de her ting, som bliver afhængige af, og det kvæler os.
And they inoculate us against the hunger for God.
De vaccinerer os mod sulten for Gud.
A passion for the kingship of Jesus.
En passion for Jesus Guds rige.
And all this stuff in our lives, it gives us kind of pseudo satisfaction.
Og alle de ting vi har i livet, jamen det er jo en pseudo tilfredshed.
It's like spiritual candy floss.
Det er jo ligesom only candy floss.
Do you have candy floss?
Har I candy floss? Har vi candy floss her?
You know, candy floss is, you know, when you're a kid, you just want
Når
candy floss.
Når du er barn, så vil du bare have candy floss.
It's big.
Oh, det er kæmpestort.
It looks incredible.
Det ser fantastisk ud.
You take one mouthful.
Og man tager en kæmpestor mundfuld.
And it's gone.
Og så er det væk. No.
Disappears.
Det er bare væk. Det forsvinder.
It's like the enemy is set on providing us with illusions of glory.
Det er ligesom om, at fjenden, han bare vil give os illusioner af ære.
That they're not glory and they will not satisfy.
De er ikke ære, og det vil ikke tilfredsstille.
But they will keep you from seeking the one for whose glory you're supposed to live.
Men de vil holde dig fra at søge den ære, som du skal søge.
Because
den,
it's given you a little bit of glory.
Fordi det giver dig en lille smule ære.
A little bit of satisfaction.
En lille smule tilfredshed.
We got to clean the backyard, guys.
Vi er nødt til at få gjort rent i baghaven.
We got to clean the backyard.
Vi er nødt til at gøre rent i baghaven.
If the nation is going to be freed up, the people need to be free.
Hvis nationen skal gøres fri, så skal folket blive frit.
Let me read a quote to you.
Lad mig læse et citat for jer.
This is from an old school Englishman.
Og det er fra en gammelagtig engelskmand.
Oh. My friend's been told that he's been told to sit down whenever I sit down.
Jeg er nødt til at sidde ned, når han sidder ned. Derfor,
and stand up whenever I stand
stå,
up.
Når jeg står op, og sidder, når vi sidder ned.
This is from a guy called William Law, who wrote a book called A Serious Call to a Devout and Holy Life.
Det her er fra en fyr, der hedder William Law, som har skrevet en bog, der hedder
A Serious Call to a Devout and Holy Life.
Et seriøst kald til et helligt og devoted liv.
Ja. Yeah. You wouldn't buy it on Amazon.
Du kan ikke købe den på Amazon.
But he says this about 300 years ago, he was the inspiration behind Wesley and Whitfield's revivals.
Cirka 300 år siden, hvor han var bagved og inspirationen.
If you will stop here and ask yourself,
hvis du vil stoppe her, stop op og spørg dig selv,
why you are not as pious as the primitive Christians were.
Hvorfor er du ikke så hellig som de primitive kristne var?
Your own heart will tell you.
Så vil dit eget hjerte fortælle dig.
That it is neither through ignorance nor inability.
At det ikke igennem uvidenhed eller mangel på færdigheder.
But purely because you never thoroughly intended it.
Men kun fordi du aldrig ønskede det 100%.
Guys, I think that the Lord has got me here just to give you a very simple message.
Så jeg tror at Gud han har bragt mig her til bare for at give jer en meget simpel besked.
And the message is this.
Og beskeden er det her.
Do you know who you are, mighty warriors?
Ved I, hvem I er, mægtige krigere?
Will you clear your backyards?
Vil I gøre rent i jeres baghaver?
Because I'm setting you up.
Fordi jeg kalder jer.
And if you know the story of Gideon,
og hvis I kender Gideons historie,
you will know that he sees incredible victory.
Så vil I vide, at han ser utrolige sejre.
And I want to tell you prophetically, if you do those things, if you understand who you are, and you clear your backyard, God is going to do something incredible with you. He's going to ruin you for the ordinary.
Og jeg vil fortælle dig, profetisk, at hvis du gør det, hvis du går ind i det 100%, og hvis du renser din baghave, så vil Gud give dig sejre, der ligner dette.
He's going to ruin you for the rational.
Han vil ruinere dig for det rationelle.
So Gideon has to go up against 135,000 warriors with 300 men.
Gideon, han skal op imod 135,000 krigere med 300 mænd.
And we haven't got time now because we've had to do two sermons.
Og vi har ikke tid nu, fordi vi skal gøre to prædikener her.
But if we had time, you would understand that God is going to give you, as he's given Gideon, divine strategies to defeat strongholds.
Men hvis du havde tid til det, så vil du se, at Gud han vil give dig de strategier, de guddommelige strategier, der skal til for at bryde og nedlægge de her fæstninger.
And if you press into this,
og hvis I bare presser ind i det her,
God is going to give you a new respect for godly leadership.
så vil Gud give jer en ny respekt for gudlig lederskab.
You're going to lose your cynicism.
I er nødt til at miste det kyniske.
That is a device of the enemy to prevent you breaking through.
Det er simpelthen et redskab for fjenden, der forhindrer jer i gennembrud.
And God is going to do something about the consumerism in your churches.
Og Gud, han vil gøre noget ved forbrugerkulturen i din kirke.
You know, in Scotland it may not be true here, but in Scotland I have
Scotland, det er måske ikke det samme her, men i Skotland.
I have a whole bunch of what I call Dyson vacuum cleaner Christians.
Og så har jeg en hel masse støvsuger kristne, som jeg kalder dem.
You know, feed me.
Som bare suger ind og bare siger, giv mig mad.
Look after my children.
Se efter mine børn, pas på dem.
Pastor me.
Vær præst for mig.
No.
Nej.
We believe in the priesthood of all believers.
Vi tror på det almene præsteskab.
Everyone gets to play.
Alle får lov at deltage.
Everyone gets a dream.
Alle får lov at drømme.
Everyone gets called a mighty warrior.
Alle bliver kaldt for en mægtig kriger.
Everyone has to deal with the rubbish in their back garden.
Og alle, de skal gøre noget ved det, der er i deres baghave.
Everyone gets to be free, so that everyone gets to be free.
Alle, de bliver fri, de er fri. Så alle andre også kan være frie.
Will you stop hiding in wine presses?
Så lad være med at gemme dig i vinpresseren.
Will you stop playing small?
Lad være med at spille som
en
lille dreng.
It doesn't do you any credit or God any honor.
Det giver ikke dig noget respektabilitet, og det giver ikke Gud nogen ære.
And will you stand, mighty warrior?
Og vil du stå op, mægtige kriger?
Would you stand, mighty warrior?
Stå op, mægtige kriger.
Stand, mighty warrior.
Stå op, mægtige kriger.
Would you stand, mighty warrior?
Stå op, mægtige kriger.
And would you not just stand, but would you receive?
Og ikke bare stå, men modtag.
Would you receive from the Spirit the power to do what He's asking you to do?
Modtag for ånden kraften til at gøre det Gud kalder dig til.
It's going to be unpopular.
Det vil være upopulært.
It's going to make a noise.
Det larmer.
It's going to shine a light.
Det lyser.
It's going to upset some people.
Det gør nogen utilfredse.
And it's going to change a nation.
Og det kommer til at forandre en nation.
Because see what God will do with 300 whose lives are changed.
Prøv for at se hvad Gud han vil gøre med 300 hvis liv er forandret.
Let's pray.
Lad os bede.
So Holy Spirit, we just invite you to come again.
Helligånd, vi beder dig om at komme her igen.
And would you whisper in hearts and lives?
Hvisker i hjerter og i liv.
Stand, mighty warrior.
Stå. Mægtige kriger.
And in these moments, would you remind my brothers and sisters of the dreams?
Og mind mine brødre og søster om drømmene.
And would you break off of everyone?
Og vil du bryde af alle dem?
The words that have been spoken that have limited.
Vil du bryde alle de ord, der er blevet talt til dem, som er en forhindring?
Not for you, not for now. Sit down.
Ikke til dig. Ikke til nu. Sid der ned.
Don't get ahead of yourself.
Kom ikke foran dig.
Don't make a noise.
Lad være alarm.
You're embarrassing.
Du er pinlig.
It can never happen.
Det kan aldrig ske.
And would you replace those thoughts?
Fjern de ord.
With the power and instruction of the Holy Spirit of God.
Og kom med instruktionen fra den Gud, den hellige ånd.
And would you transform us for the nation?
Forvandle os for nationen.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Kom, Helligånd.
Let's just respond to the Lord.
Lad os bare respondere på det, Herren gør.
There are some here that God has called to apostolic leadership.
Der er nogen her, som Gud han har kaldet til apostolsk lederskab.
And you haven't had permission for it, and you haven't had vocabulary for it.
Og du har ikke haft tilladelse til det, og du har ikke haft sprog.
But as I've been speaking, the Holy Spirit has been reminding you of a dream, a pioneering dream that He's given you, and He's saying, "Stand, mighty warrior."
Men mens jeg har talt, så har Helligånden mindet dig om drømmen. And some of you, har sagt til dig, stå op, mægtige kriger.
And some of you have been squashed or felt that you've been squashed.
Og nogle af jer, I er blevet presset og trykt sammen.
Because of personality and gift and gender.
På grund af personlighed, gave og køn.
And the Lord says, stand, mighty warrior.
Og Gud siger, stå, mægtige kriger.
Let's just respond to the Lord. Let's just worship Him.
Lad os vente på Herren, respondere på Herren, lad os tilbede.
And as we worship, if you want to say to the Lord significantly today.
Og hvis du, mens vi tilbeder her, vil sige signifikant til Gud.
If he's been speaking to you,
hvis han har talt til dig,
can I encourage you not to leave this place without doing business with him?
Så vil jeg bare opmuntre til, at du skal ikke forlade det her sted, før du er gået frem foran ham.
And one of the ways that you can do that,
og en af de måder, du kan gøre det på,
is to come and kneel at the front.
Det er at komme her frem på scenen og knæle ned.
And your kneeling will say, I'm up for being set up.
Og din knælen, det vil sige, Gud, kald mig.
And the ministry team will come, they'll lay a hand on you and they'll just bless what God is doing.
Og forbønsteamet vil komme, og de vil lægge hånden på dig og velsigne, hvad Gud gør.
They won't counsel you or answer your questions.
De vil ikke være rådgivere for dig, de vil ikke svare på dine spørgsmål.
They will just bless what God is doing.
De vil bare velsigne, hvad Gud allerede gør.
They will bless what God is doing.
De vil velsigne, hvad Gud gør.
So you just come, you just respond.
Så kom, responder.
Not to me, to him.
Ikke til mig, til ham.
Not to me, to him.
Ikke til mig, til ham. Velsigne, hvad er I?